Hey guys, welcome back to Resident Evil 3. Let's carry on where we left off. We've only got hours to go before the nuclear blast incinerates us and all of Raccoon City. So we gotta get a move on. Tyrell's trying to contact Uncle Sam to delay things, but something tells me he doesn't have them on speed dial, so it may take a bit of time. Our best bet, obviously, is to follow that handsome son of a bitch, Carlos, the one who defended Jill and the hospital lobby from an onslaught of zombies, and see if we can work together to get out of here. First, I gotta go to the treatment room, though. There's explosives components that I should collect. There we are. I think that's everything of the entire hospital. Yep, it is. All right. Let's go. I feel like we're in the end game now. I have heard that this game is quite short, and well, honestly, it feels like it is, kind of, a little bit. But that's okay. I don't mind. It's been an intense ride so far. Oh, shit. Company! We've got company! Oh, come on! Off me! I just needed to get through the damn door! Okay. We have no healing. That's not good. Equip this and just shoot it. Right at our feet, because we can, because it's a Resident Evil game. That's one way to survive. Shit. Nothing to heal us? That's alright. All this stuff we've amassed. Remaster of unlocking. That's Jill, alright. That means every lock has been unlocked, I'm guessing? Probably. Alright. Yep, sure does. We can discard the lockpicks, which can make room for some herbs. Hopefully we find some. How did Carlos get through here? He doesn't have the lockpicks. And the lock was still on the door. Hmm. Doesn't matter. He probably just stared at the lock and it submitted out of fear. Okay, handgun ammo. That's not quite what I was looking for, but I'll take what I can get. Any more of those gigantic frog freak things? Doesn't look like it. Where are we? The hospital's loading bay?
Oh, this must be the way in front.
Ah, to the lab, I suppose, where they were developing the vaccine. That's where Carlos was going after. The remnants of the vaccine. Let's combine these, free up some more space. That'll give us some flame rounds. Nice. Okay. Take us down. Last thing I need is to get infected again. So, having more of the vaccine would probably help. Hopefully I can avoid, like, launching a grenade at my feet. That was almost cheating, wasn't it? Just to get out of a tough situation. I'd rather incinerate myself than get bitten again.
How is it no one in the hospital ever noticed all this?
Because they were too busy tending to a bunch of zombies coming through their doors, and they were hiding in the staff room writing notes, saying, "Help me, this is my final work," and then interrupted. Okay, well, I'll keep it. I don't want to use it just yet. I want to find at least a red herb before I have to make use of it. Lower that. Damn you. You'd think Carlos, with the amount of first aid kits, or first aid sprays and herbs he has in his inventory, he'd leave some, like, lying around for us when we came through. We've just recovered from getting infected by a good old Nemesis. You know, I could really use some healing. All he's left is one tiny herb. And a safe room. At least he brought the typewriter with him. Elevator notice. To all employees, we've identified an issue with the electrical box where concurrent use of heavy machinery overloads it and causes the fuses to blow. If you encounter this problem and can't get the elevator running, please stay calm, gather fuses from the sub-generators situated around the warehouse, and use those to restore power from the main generator as quickly as possible. Okay, so I'm guessing the elevator is not running. We're gonna need to gather some fuses and restore power. Another hip pouch. Handy. Any achievement for that? Doesn't look like it. That's a door leading out. Right, let me save. Okay, I knew I had a red herb in my inventory box, so there we are. We managed to heal up. Okay, now, should we try this door first? Nope, of course it's locked, so we're going this way, I guess. Here we are. Oh, who's that? Nikolai. Well, that probably explains why all the herbs were gone. Maybe Carlos was a generous soul and left them for us, but then... Hello? Can you see me? I can't tell if he's looking at me or he's on an important phone call with probably the president. Okay, well, maybe we got a boss fight coming up. Nope, can't go through the stairs. Looks like we're gonna have to drop down. Yeah, this looks like a boss fight arena or something. Okay, here goes. Ugh, I'm at your mercy now, Nikolai. Well, he still doesn't care. Okay, well, shit. Can't use that. Alright, I'm coming up then. Wonder if he's getting like a commendation. Like, Nikolai, you're doing a very good job of cleaning the city. We haven't told you about the nuclear blast yet because, quite frankly, we're scared of you and we want to clean up the mess. So, consider this your last minute warning. Oh, shit.
I must admit,
right, well, that's
I respect you to
the
nurse,
elevator fuses that we need to go
but
after.
I'm afraid our games end here.
You think this is over?
Okay, the game's not that short, I know that much. We're not ending the game right here. Thank you very much. Okay, where are we going then? He's still there. Gather the fuses, it said. So we need to find those generators of sorts. Stairs are still blocked. Can we use this now? Oh shit! What the hell? Oh my. It's getting closer. He won't go down. Okay, alright, alright, shotgun it is then. Right, you know what? Forget it. Let's just move. Maybe this thing's indestructible. Okay, come on, Jill, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Up the elevator, up the elevator. Whew. See you later. Didn't really want your company. Oh, got some boxes there. This is one of the fuses. Fuse 3. Hunt for fuses 1 out of 3. Good, good. Got another herb, some shotgun shells. Lovely. Where do we get the rest? Can't go back on that catwalk. Do we go back down? There's another way down here. Let's go. Oh, jeez. Whoa! Any more? We got zombie dogs? How the hell did they get down here? Okay, surely that's that other zombie, right? So what, we're just going through all the enemies of the game down here? We got lickers and those giant toad things coming after us? Okay, we got an elevator here, but I can't find the switch for it. All good. Okay, whoa, jeez. What the heck's happening? Is this Nikolai's doing? Otherwise, this place honestly needs to follow its health and safety practices a little better. He is in a hurry to get to me. Not quite. There we are. Alright, knife test. Oh, I think he's actually dead. Amazing. Someone actually passed the knife test. First try.
Dead end. No, wait.
See what you did there, Jill. Dead end. Get it? Because there was a zombie here. Okay, never mind, don't worry. Dad jokes. Red herb. I think I can combine those two. Right, that's better. Bit of a buffer in case things go south. Which is likely. Is this the switch? That elevator. Okay, we got some stairs here. Can we use the stairs? Okay, got a door. Is that door? Maybe it leads towards the save room? Hang on, let's use the elevator. Just curious to see where this leads us. From my calculations, it looks like it just leads us back to where the stairs are. Yeah, okay. Well, that's something then. Well, good. Well, let's go in here. Oh, friends. That's a big spread. Okay, around them, around them. No time for knife tests. Shotgun shells. Yeah, we're just gonna have to kick them. Ooh. That's the door to the save room, I think. Yes, good. So there was another door there we could use. Alright, oh, hello. Towards the door, Jill. Come on. Down here. Anything there? No. Gunpowder. These things have arrived. Whoa, 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 whoa. That was fast. Not wasting any time on that front. We've got a few grenades left, so that's fine, right? Fuse number two. Our inventory's full. Shit. Damn, fuses are taking up my precious inventory space. Okay, hang on. Before we head back to the save room, let me see if I can make some room here. Got gunpowder. No. Okay. Let's head back to the save room. Don't know where that other zombie is, I'm just running it. Jeez, man, do you have to, like, wait right out the door? Goodness, give me some space. Cleared up some room in my inventory. Found gunpowder that I turned into shotgun shells. Turned the explosives into grenades. And I figure, hopefully, the game lets us just put the fuses straight onto the elevator without having to get all three of them at once. So we can quickly just place them in there rather than keep them in the item box, right? Might be a better idea. Better use of our time and space. Whoa. That was a classic zombie moan. Love that. Plug that in. Does it have to be in any order? Well, I mean, we're just missing fuse number one now, aren't we? Okay, we need to call that lift back down, I think. Because those stairs are blocked, conveniently. Jill's like, I don't have time to throw stuff down. Alright, juke him. Kite him around. Let's go, let's go. You're not invited, you're not invited. Last thing I need is him trapped on this lift with me while we go up slowly. Probably to my doom. Okay, there was nothing here, right? I mean, this whole place is red. Does that mean that I'm missing stuff? Or what? Not quite sure. I mean, I haven't been very thorough, to be honest. Quite nervous about encountering enemies. Handgun ammo. Good. Could use some of that. Right. One more fuse. I think I know which way we need to go. That's a dead end. So we go through here. Nice. Sliding through like a snake, Jill. Call the elevator down and we'll go up. Actually, should have used the stairs. Damn it, made a bridge. Never mind. Oh, we got a case. What's this? Shell holder for the shotgun. Allows for faster reload speeds. Yes, please. Okay, well, maybe that's the silver lining for pulling that elevator down then. Everything's still red though, so there must be more than meets the eye. Okay, this way I think leads to the last fuse. That's gonna pull that elevator up, which will make a bridge. Looks like Nikolai has just skedaddled out of here. Don't blame the guy. Just watching me raise and lower these lifts. probably made him, like, quite nervous about my puzzle-solving skills. I mean, this place would have been a logistical nightmare to, like, arrange things, wouldn't it? That didn't sound very good. There's the fuse. Okay, alright. What are you unloading on us? Oh, we just got zombies. Oh, shit. Okay. Freak it out. Trapped between a rock and a hard place. Okay. Oh, no! Oh, no! Oh! Whoa. Grenade! I don't know what's happening. I'm just running around shooting grenades and shit. Okay, looks like you're the last woman standing. I mean, I'm the last woman standing. You're the last undead woman standing. Not anymore. You fell to the ground. Knife test. Nope, you got blisters and shit all over your body. Some of these guys. Shouldn't have to do the knife test, right? They all exploded in a ball of flames. Last fuse. Fuse number one.
Right, here goes.
Okay. Is there anything in here we can use? Ooh, look at this. Gunpowder all over the show. Honestly, I'd prefer shotgun shells at this point in time. I mean, don't get me wrong, the pistol's got its uses, but right now, I've got like 31 shotgun shells. And, well, they all must go, so let's make use of them. Green herb. Nice. Anything else? Okay, so these containment units are blue, but this floor here is red. So maybe there's some stuff lying around. Let me just have a quick look. Doesn't look like there's anything left down here. Fair enough. Let's head back up. Just gotta plug in that last fuse, and then we're good to go. Excellent. I'm nervous I might have missed something else, like, you know, my Desert Eagle doesn't have any attachments. We found an attachment for the shotgun. You're still here. Employee memo. September 12, admitted to N2, male 45, female 32, discarded, male 60, female 89. Whoa. September 15, admitted to N2, males 55, 19, female 51, discarded female 76, returned female 8, uninfected. September 22, admitted to N2, males 25, 22, 15, female 16, 21, 29, discarded 6 male specimens, 9 female specimens, disposals trending upwards daily, preemptively dispose of any over 30 years of age. Wow. 15 years old, 16 years old, female, and 15 year old male, that is. Whew, that's heavy. September 24, nightly transfer observed by nurse, admissions to underground facility temporarily halted. Because, you know, we're full, so we're just going to back everyone up. Up top. That suddenly became 6 rounds. Hey. Just going to preemptively shoot him. And run inside. Alright, Nikolai. I'm ready for your fun and games. I'm sure I missed a thing or two. Okay. Well, that was highly ineffective. Okay, alright. Go on, got tentacles flying around and shit. Go on, get the hell off me. What the hell? Are you trying to mindfuck me? Go. Put that last fuse in, Jill. Up we go. Up we go, I said. Ugh. Pursue Nikolai is our objective. We're in caution.
Shit, he got away.
What a surprise, he had like a half an hour head start. Another save room, item box. Looks like he was observing. Unfinished activity log. 26th of September, 1300, infiltrated RC, Raccoon City. Disturbances are sporadic, commencing mission, 1930. Observed 5 RPD officers engaging a pack 20 strong. Officers annihilated in 20 minutes. 27th of September, 1200, twist and run at university, diverted pack, including canines to campus. 64% infection and conversion in 2 hours, no survivors. 2300, successful rendezvous with MB Platoon. We'll make first attempt at dawn. So they deliberately infected the city, but why? 28th of September of 0430, diverted pack toward command post. Results, night skirmish in confined area with large number of combatants. Video attached. 0800, end of skirmish, 7 survivors. That must be what Mikhail was talking about when he locked the door or something and everyone got killed. 0800, end of skirmish, 7 survivors. 1800, unknown bioweapon deployed at point D18. Tracking it per orders, it appears to be on the hunt. That must be Nemesis. 2000 hours, got eyes on 2 stars, a male infected and female. Bioweapon is pursuing the female. That was Brad. 29th of September, 0100 hours. Female JV has made contact with MB Platoon. JV Jill Valentine. Bioweapon's appearance and behavior are consistent with Project N, investigating Project Nemesis. 0400, observed bioweapon wielding conventional weapons, flamethrowers, and rocket launchers. Seems to be strongly fixated on terminating JV and knows the city layout. Evidence it can be imprinted. 0700, metamorphosis in the bioweapon triggered by the hostile encounter with JV. Video attached. JV has been infected and is non-responsive. Collected samples per orders. 030, over 17 hours have elapsed since JV's exposure to the virus. Conversion has been slow, suggesting she may be resistant. Yeah, she hung in there, didn't she? That's 30th of September. 0400, vaccine recovered and administered to JV by CO Carlos. A soldier in MV platoon. JV expected to be fit for combat approx 20 hours post-exposure. It seems clear the bioweapon is Project N. Contact with JV causes it to change and evolve. Will induce further encounters to obtain more precise data. So how did he know that I was cured by Carlos? Maybe we're on the surveillance footage or something. Who's that?
Joe.
Tyrell?
Tyrell.
How did you make it through all that shit? Goodness.
I got through. They're willing to negotiate.
The zombies?
Ah.
Oh, right, you got through to the government.
They'll call off the strike if, and this is one big ass if, we can deliver the vaccine to them before they launch.
Tyrell, you alright, dude?
How long do we have?
Hours, maybe.
Then let's not waste one more second.
This way.
Alright, Tyrell. Shit. Let's get moving then. Hang on. Alright, wait up. Wait up. I'm coming. Sorry, just needed to save and whatnot. This room is red. Is there anything lying around? That's Nikolai didn't want me to see. Ah, case. Extended barrel for my Desert Eagle. I knew there'd be an attachment. Combine. So what does that do? Both power and accuracy. Alright, let's move. I'll introduce my Desert Eagle to Nikolai's face.
We'll find the vaccine up ahead.
That'll be a fitting end to his report. Tyrell, you don't stand in front of doors like that. Okay, you could get grabbed, or worse. Tentacled. Mindfucked. A tube down your mouth or throat.
Sure you don't need to stop?
Cause
stop and do what? I got your back.
I need a break too, look at me.
Alright, let's get this done.
Well, we're just a bunch of injured soldiers heading into the dragon's den. What could possibly go wrong? I mean, Carlos is down there. You alright? Okay. That doesn't sound good. Oh, Tyrell, dude, you made it so far! No, Jill, the Desert Eagle! That's Nemesis!
No! Keep going. We're almost there.
Come on, dude. You made it this far. Oh, fuck. No! Tyrell! I liked you! Oh, he was too good for this world. Nemesis definitely isn't. Oh, we're running. Ah, he's fast! Oh, that was quite a quick door. Could have been sliced in half, Jill. Or worse, the Jill sandwich. Get the vaccine, the pursuer. Achievement unlocked. Yeah, please decontaminate me. Goodness knows what Nemesis has been protracting, swimming in the creek and going through the sewers and shit. Speaking of, I haven't had a proper shower since the sewers as well, so that was helpful. Oh, yep, dry me. Yeah, cool. Good. Right. The heart of Umbrella now. Okay, who am I kidding? These guys won't react until some scripted event happens. That's locked. Maybe I need to cut off someone's hand. This is unlocked. Ooh, another save room. They're everywhere. Nest 2 employee regulations. Attention Nest 2 employees. The objectives of this T-Virus research facility differ from those of Umbrella's main Nest facility. Here we focus on real-world use cases which arise as new bioweapons are created and introduced, such as the need for T-Virus vaccines, a new weaponry capable of suppressing bioweapons. Some aspects of our work here can be dangerous, so it is imperative that all employees adhere to workplace regulations without fail. In particular, unauthorized entry by unapproved visitors, or the removal of work-related data, or materials will be met with severe disciplinary measures. It is a great honor to be part of the finest research organization in the world. Keep this in mind, and stick to the rules, as we forge new and revolutionary technologies. S2 map. Well, there's not a lot going on, so there's that. I mean, never mind. This is the first floor. Got the second floor, basement 1, and basement 2. Okay, Jill. Let's gear up and continue our escape by going deeper into Umbrella. It seems kinda counterintuitive, but trust me, this will lead us out of the city. Well, since we're on our way to escaping this place, I figure we should probably grab that vaccine as we head out of the city. I'm sure the US government would be quite pleased. Surprised Umbrella hasn't, you know, wiped it out completely already. Damn, where are we going? Suppose we just go down this way? PA system's still working, that's a good sign. Oh! Whoops, sorry, didn't mean to knock you from your nice little slumber. Good to know that some of them actually can be stabbed. Bad news is they actually wake up. Partial lockdown? There's a zombie apocalypse and you're only partially locking down? Gosh. These guys clearly just want everyone to keep working with a partial lockdown. Isaac Graves' diary. The pay was generous. The benefits were good. Most importantly, they promised me I'd be contributing to state-of-the-art medical tech research. For a university teacher stuck working in nowhere America, it was a golden opportunity. Like winning the lottery. So I went for it. I made the pitch to my family, and we agreed to move here to Raccoon City. Well, hindsight is 2020. Because this lab is a den of monsters who conduct cruel and barbaric experiments for the sole purpose of taking human life in the most sickening way possible. It's messed up. The world needs to know. But every time I work up enough courage to blow the whistle, I think of Penny and Casey and immediately chicken out. Umbrella owns this town. There was this guy they caught trying to smuggle out company secrets. They essentially fed him to one of the betas. Fed him! I saw the whole thing! I got my wife and daughter into this. I just need to do my job. Do as I'm told, for their sake. But let this be a testament that I do have a conscience and that I've learned my lesson. I mean, couldn't you have tried to get them out of town? I mean, I understand your family's at risk, but genocide? Oof. Talk about being caught between a rock and a hard place. Alright, well, Mr. Isaac Graves, I hope your family is okay. Damn it, they were recruiting university teachers? Stab this guy. He doesn't look like a zombie, so yeah. Goes right through him. What's in here? It's not labeled, but it's quite a wide open room, which has me nervous. Let's just wander around slowly. More high-grade gunpowder. Yep, combine the two, and then we'll combine the mag ammo there. I mean, I might as well make use of my Desert Eagle. I've got quite a lot of bullets for it, and I don't know when I'm going to be able to use it. Alright, he's okay. Let's just load this up. What was this room for, I wonder? All the science stuff.
To begin vaccine synthesis, place the materials in the chamber.
Ah. So we have to synthesize the vaccine. Synthesis? It's not already done.
I have to make it myself? Alright, gotta figure this out.
Alright, Dr. Valentine's on the job. Essay on vaccine synthesis. on the roles of antigens and adjuvants in vaccine synthesis. Dr. Nathaniel Bard, chief researcher, Spencer Memorial Hospital. To most efficiently synthesize a vaccine, both an antigen and an adjuvant are required. The antigen produces an immune response, while the adjuvant increases the effects of such responses, leading to increased antibody production. By combining samples of these two ingredients, one can create a potent vaccine base. By processing this vaccine base with our proprietary equipment, a larger batch of vaccine can be created with astonishing ease. What's more, my latest antigen and adjuvant samples yield unprecedented rates of antibody production, producing more than 1,000 times the yield of traditional materials. This not only makes it an effective vaccine, but also a potential way to eliminate existing infections. Right, so we just need to find an antigen and an adjuvant, whatever they are. I mean, what could possibly go wrong? We could just end up like one of these researchers. See, science killed them. What do we have here?
Override key successfully generated.
Oh, cool.
What have we here?
Override key removed.
Ah, flash drive. So I guess this will let us get through some of the locks in this area. It's a biometric key. Something tells me since I grabbed that, we might have some company. Let's keep an eye out. Down we go. This place is too brightly lit. It has me nervous. No, it's like giving me a false sense of security. Plug that in.
Override complete.
I don't know how commonplace USBs were in 1998, but I mean, they must have a place in history. Oh, there's quite a few of those guys. Alright, definitely equipping this bad boy now. Knocked him down. Just run past him. Just stumble up the stairs. Might be something down below. Yep, it's red. But I don't have time to dick around with those fools. Is this the antigen? I might need to clear up some inventory space as well, actually. Well, that was simple. Culture sample.
Oh, an antigen sample. I'll definitely need this for the vaccine.
Good. Good to know. Let's use our shotgun shell so we can clear up some inventory space. Weaponry authorization request. Dear Dr. Emerson, I would like to formally request that the weaponry normally reserved for the bioweapon synthesis team be made available for any employees interfacing with the admission and dismissal of test subjects. These test subjects do not present the same levels of danger as our bioweapon products, but I believe that this weaponry authorization is advisable as outlined below. Recently, some test subjects have developed a new mutation granting them very high regrowth abilities. Our team refers to these specimens as pale heads, so that must be what's waiting for me outside this door. Pale heads. They have been appearing with regularity, but the specific cause has not yet been determined. The astonishing rate at which these pale heads regenerate makes it difficult to deliver a lethal blow with standard weaponry. If any sort of system failure were to occur within our facility, we would be woefully underprepared to defend ourselves. For this reason, I would like to request that high-powered weaponry capable of subduing the pale heads be issued to all of our employees working in shipping and processing. This will ensure that, in the event of an emergency, we will be able to quickly eliminate the threat and evacuate safely. Thank you very much for your consideration. Shipping and Processing Manager, Gabrielle Reed. Well, luckily I did a female voice. Wasn't anticipating that it was going to be signed by a female. Just thought it would be a nice change of pace. Okay, he's out and about. What sort of weaponry do we need? That was a panic shot, sorry. Oh no, that guy's still dead on the ground. Excuse me. Hard to step over you when you're all over the staircase. The heck? Where'd you come from? Hang on. Ah, hiding there, are you? Looks like they are weak to this. Grab the herb. Combine. Can we just make three? Mixed herb, GGG. Indeed. It's not enough to just say good game. We have to say good goddamn game. GGG. Where does this lead now? Ooh, I need to get my bearings. Gunpowder, got a laptop. Can't check what's on it. This guy's not a zombie, so... Yep. Nothing from that front. This music's ramping up, I like it. It's down here. Not gonna get ambushed, am I?
This must be what powers it.
Not this guy. Surely not. Stab his eyes so he can't see me. Alright. Push it in. What numbnuts pulled that out? Unless it was to defend us from whatever was behind that door. In which case, I'm the numbnut for pushing the generator back in. Okay. I am kind of wounded. Might be worth healing. Open that up. Whoa. Is that Mr. X? And those are those toad things? Jeez.
These are tyrants.
Tyrants?
Jesus. Is this where they're made?
I guess so. Right in this briefcase. Last thing I want is to face all of them. So whatever we need to do here, let's make it quick. Although I feel like I'm blitzing through this facility rather quickly. Okay, up we go. Where is this gonna take us? Honestly, I have no idea where I'm going. He's not a zombie, no need to knife test you! Only infected. The mortally challenged, as Doom Eternal calls him. Another attaché case.
Out of the way!
Vaccine needs to be made. Hey. Wow, there's a lot of you. Jeez, one at a time. Good. Alright. I'm actually kind of burning through my Desert Eagle ammo rather quickly. So let's slow down. Explosive B. Combine these two. Acid rounds. Haven't used those yet. Though I'm sure there's a time and a place for it. Sorry. Why am I apologizing? It's a zombie. Oof. Sorry. Gonna have to leave those behind. Gunpowder, though. Now I can pick it up. Hooray! For inventory management. Got an expression of concern. Senior fellow Dr. Frankel, please allow me to send my heartfelt congratulations to you and your colleagues at Umbrella Europe for completing Nemesis, a truly remarkable achievement in the field of bioweapons research. Introducing a parasitic organism into a tyrant's brain to gain external control of it? How can I not marvel at such a wild idea? However, from a medical perspective, I must emphatically state my disapproval of this shift away from established Umbrella policy. By turning to the use of parasites, you are setting a dangerous precedent. Viruses can be kept in check. I believe an effective vaccine can be developed for any virus on Earth, with abundant funding and a bounty of samples, of course. Can you say the same for parasites, however? Doctors have tried in vain to develop a vaccine for malaria. Parasites like Plasmodium are far more genetically complex than the T-virus, and to think they will submit to control is utter folly. Perhaps in your country, consumers are willing to buy automobiles with no brakes, but here in America, they know better. Then again, I recall you have a degree in economics, so no doubt you have already devised a brilliant marketing strategy to win over the naysayers. I look forward to your talk at the forum in Berlin next month. In the meantime, I shall be exploring medical solutions to this hubristic problem you've foisted on us. Sincerely, Nathaniel Bard, PhD.
So it's called the Nemesis.
Yep, that's a very fitting name. Okay. Oh, there's still something in the incubation lab, probably another sample. There it is. Liquid-filled test tube. No space. Alright, let's just heal up then.
An adjuvant sample. These are combined with antigens to increase immune system response.
See? Jill knows her stuff. Gosh, you were doubting her, guys? Terrible. Okay, what's gonna happen once we go downstairs? I feel like all those toads are gonna escape. I'm so paranoid, I'm like anticipating all these encounters. When I first grabbed the antigen sample or whatever, nothing happened. But come on, this room is just bad news. Oh, let's go. I'm running. Ah, shit! I knew it. As soon as I saw that control panel go red, I know I'm kind of cheating by by equipping my grenade launcher from the inventory menu. More. Come here. Oh shit. Probably should have reloaded first. Oh. We're in caution, that's fine. Reload. Ah, Jill, you need a dodge, man. Faster next time, please. Equip this. Any more? Open the damn door! Oh, how convenient. Probably because it was a quarantined response. Oof. Need some more healing items, I've used them all. What's up with this guy? Okay. Scientist's dying message. It happened. Our worst case scenario. The T-virus has somehow leaked. Under orders from Dr. Bard, I'm to manufacture mass quantities of the vaccine. I've propelled a culture of the T-virus antigen. Now I just need to combine it with an adjuvant to enhance its effects, and I should be able to produce enough vaccine to save all the surviving citizens. The adjuvant samples are stored in the incubation lab. The test subjects are already wandering the halls, but I'd better find a way to get some samples while this culture is maturing. If I don't make it back, please complete the synthesis process. Try to find a way to stop this outbreak. It's the least we can do after setting these horrifying events in motion. Okay, dodge quickly backwards in case I get grabbed. Uh-oh. You're back. If you ever died. Just sit still for a second. Thanks. That's all I needed. Come on, back to the save room. We're almost there, Jill. Just gotta make the vaccine.